Julian's just popped over from Edinburgh, haven't you, Julian? Julian. Julian.
Oh, are we on?
We're on. Julian's a bit tired because he went to bed really early last night. It doesn't agree with him early nights, does it?
Shall we get a bit closer?
Ah, go on then. We don't want people talking.
I'm worried about that cameraman.
Oh, don't. They're ripped that. Which one? This one here?
The one who looks about 12.
They all look about 12.
You won't understand some of my jokes. Maybe you'll fill him in later.
I will do.
As it were.
He's new. He's one of these YTSs, so we'll probably shake.
We'll see to that.
We'll stiffen you up, don't you worry? Yes. What was Edinburgh like?
Oh, well, you know how it is.
Too nice, is it?
It was fun. There was a bit of drama.
Was there?
Mm. Well, just before I started the show the other night, the police were sent for because...
What did you do?
No, I didn't do anything. Someone was drunk in the audience, which is very unusual.
For Edinburgh?
For Edinburgh.
I've never seen a drunk in an audience at Edinburgh.
And they handcuffed him and took him away. I thought they were bringing him to my dressing room.
And they didn't?
They didn't, know.
Why did they handcuff him?
Well, so he wouldn't leave. He paid his money and he wanted, you know... be entertained.
Should have gone out and said, here's your fiver back, get lost, or whatever it is.
It was more than a fiver, thank you very much. See me in the flesh. For God's sake.
I've seen you doing it for less than a fiver in the flesh. I'm not going into it now, but I have done it in the past.
I'm not some cheap tart at the Vauxhall Tavern, you know.
What are you incinerating?
No, I like common people.
I do as well. I don't mix with them much, but I like them.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lily Savage.
That was an effort. Tell you, that wasn't easy getting down them stairs dragging that thing behind me. It's like two bags of coal. Anyway, good evening. No, it was a rhetorical suggestion. I didn't want to reply. But that was a big word. Rhetorical. Don't even know what it means, but I said it. Welcome to another edition of Blankety Blank, the game show that is fun, 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 all the way campus. And where would we be without a laugh, eh? The BBC. I'm feeling catty tonight. I am proper Bette Davis. Fasten your seatbelts. It's going to be a bumpy night. Anyway, let's get on with the show, shall we? I meet tonight's stars, big stars, who are going to play Blankety Blank. God knows why. They must have been bored, but they're here anyway. So first cab off the rank is, he's the tallest man on TV, yes. He's the only man who can give me a love bite without having to stand on a box. He hasn't, like, but the night's still young, you know what I mean? So, put your hands together, please. From Catchphrase, Nick Weir. Good night, Nick. One of my favourite soaps is Emmerdale. It is. I love it. And now it's on 5 nights a week. My life's gone out the window, I tell you. It deals, you see, with things that are important to me. Rural issues in the country, you know? Teenage pregnancies, adultery, death, shoplifting, all that kind of thing that goes on in a small, remote Yorkshire village. Now, this lady is not a farmer, but as Viv Windsor, she has raised a right pair of cows. Would you please put your hands together for Dina Payne? Please welcome the man himself, Mr. Peter Kay. It's a long time since that's been done to
hey
me,
up,
Kim.
Hey up, Kim.
Do you know Kim?
Never met Kim. Senior Police Academy.
Thanks. God bless you, Peter.
Have you given to the dog, Kim?
No, I didn't bring my purse.
You've not brought your purse?
No, I'll get it off her later, Peter.
The dog.
Oh,
go on.
Good on you.
Thanks,
for the old dog's home.
Hey, yeah. Hiya, Kim.
Nice to meet you.
Are you okay,
Oh, you all right?
How are you, Flower? You're OK?
I thought I run Noel's house party then when I come in. Look at this! I like your organ.
Bit lovely, eh? Been a long time since somebody said that to me. I'll tell you.
After 9 o'clock.
I know, 9 o'clock.
Say what we want,
after 9, we can say what we like.
I was told not to swear. How
no,
about you?
No, no, you can't sit. No, I'm kidding.
No, you can't.
No, you can't.
Because I have to pay the fine, you see.
Well, no, because my mum's watching.
Oh, is she?
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, she'll be Sky Plus in this.
From Bolton, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I ring her up. I did this thing on Sunday night in Twickenham, Help the Heroes concert.
Oh, I'm a Tom James.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't see him, though. He'd gone.
Oh, has he?
And I rang her up. I said, did you like that? Did you see it? She went, have you been on? I didn't know. I wasn't watching. And I'm like, well, I've just... Your son's on television. It's all news now. No, she Sky Plus is it, and that's it.
And get rid of the adverts.
Well, you can fast forward it, but the only thing about Sky Plus is that if you have it and you go to adverts, there's no, it's all or nothing.
Yeah.
You see, because my whole life's on times 30. Everything's on times 30 now. Everything. Move forward and rewind. And then you go, put adverts on till you knock it on. And they go, whoa, 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 it's back on, it's back on. Go back, go back, go back. Not to start a program. Where are you going? Go forward, go forward. And my son, he can work the planner now. So it's all Cartoon Network during day. Yeah. It's 31. It's all Cartoon Network. So it's all... And all my programmes are failing. Because I go, what's this? Failed.
In our house, it's vampires the mad on. Every time I put Sky... Have a look. It's all this vampire... Look, what? What is this obsession with women and vampires? They rip your throat out, for God's sake.
Part record. That's my life. Part record.
And me, yeah. Or fail to record.
Fail. Or you got right at crux of it, like Poirot, backup comes up. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Or the other one, two recordings at once.
Yeah, yeah.
That's not select one. I don't know. Select it. You've got to choose. I sacrificed Law and Order other night. I couldn't watch it.
I sacrificed Miami Shark Attack. Broke my arse. Oh, it's fabulous.
When's that
You've
on?
Never seen Miami Shark Attack?
No, when's that on? What's
it's
that?
About 4 o'clock in the morning on a Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
He said, I'm desperate.
Have you got it on Series Link?
I've got it on Series
That's,
Link.
There's nothing on my planner for me, honest to God. If you get on, I say, what's on? There's nothing on here of mine. I've got two World's Strongest Men and a Ross Kemp in Bangkok. That's me. Nothing on of mine here. None of mine. My stuff's on here. Where's all my programmes?
And there's loads of you
Series
on
Series Link, 40 hours, Grey's Anatomy. That's it. There's nothing worse than the panic you get when your planner's down to 3%.
You can do all it now on your mobile, you know. Can you do it on your mobile?
Can I, Al? Have you seen my mobile?
Have you seen mine?
No, mine's murder, mine. No, no. Oh, front comes off with numbers.
Peter, mine's Baker Lice, seriously.
Don't mind us. Come on. Sorry, Kim, wrong on you.
When I took my mobile in to get changed, the guy laughed. He said, we've never seen one like this before.
What's your mobile
It was so
like?
Old.
Well, I hang on to them, because when you take it in, I say, please don't lose me numbers. And they go, no, we won't. And then they go, sorry, we've lost half your numbers.
Oh, no. That's
consequently...
Worst one's when you get a voicemail and it's someone walking on gravel. Did you ever get that?
No. Yeah.
You have a message and you play it. He says, and it's just someone going, hey, boy, you know, and they've just obviously dialed you and they don't realise it.
Oh, I've had that. They call that,
they call that a bum dial.
Do
they?
What?
Yeah, a bum dial.
Not in his world.
Because someone.
Him?
What?
That's something totally different in Birkenhead.
What?
A bum dial.
Hey.
Something totally different.
Dearest viewer, tonight, we come to the end of our Battersea adventure.
Bullseye.
I'll be okay.
Louis, come on.
I'll be back home with me pigs.
Tom.
And me lovely sheep.
Winnie, come back.
Me chickens.
Oh, stop that.
Me dogs.
And them fat arse up you go.
It's lovely to be home with me menagerie. But what about the dogs of Battersea? What'll they do without me?
Oh, you're such a lovely girl. Then I'll be walking these clogs.
Frank, this way!
Happy my friend.
Come on. Wait, come on. Frank.
Yeah, Baba.
The therapist.
He's a good girl.
The partner in crime.
Come on, big fella.
The father figure. The soulmate.
I love you. Ta-da, Carmine.
Now, stop this now, because I'm not crying on telly.
Can a fella have a whinge in peace, do you mind?
But there's time to help a few more dogs, so this week, I'm teaching some doggy sign language.
I can't get dogs with hearing to sit.
Catching up with old friend Bourbon and her tiny puppies.
Super big belly.
And saying goodbye. Stop that now, you big wuss, you don't cry on telly.
Right, you lot, line up, please. I'm going to Battersea. Olga. I catch you with that Alsatian from the village, there's going to be murder. You just behave yourself and you keep off the phone.
Ta-da.
You know, it's been sickening watching all these people skip out of the door with the new dog. I want one too, but I'm away from home too much at the moment and it wouldn't be fair. So every time I'm here, the Battersea staff and my probation officer, Joan, have to make sure I leave empty-handed.
How is he with pigs?
That's Joan.
He doesn't want to know about.
No, I can't. But today's my last day at Battersea and everyone can relax. I'm a bit sad though, to be honest. I'm going to miss all those dogs. Hang on, what's going on here?
Oh my God, what's this? What's this?
I smell a rat here.
This is embarrassing.
This is Battersea's chief exec, Claire.
Come and talk to us, come on. Come on. Like
that. And this is the guard of honour that they do for special visitors.
You have to go around like the Queen, though. Hello. Hello. Hello, darling. Oh, yes, you're beautiful. Yes, you are. Hello, Candy. Hello. What? Are you looking for a new dad, are you? Look at that face. Right, I'm moving on quick.
Well, now I've got over the shock. This is lovely. Everyone's here. Even Frank, the clever staffy I went to Crufts with.
Frank, yes.
Frank has got a very important question to ask you.
Yes.
I don't speak staffy. What did he say?
We would be delighted if you would do us the honour of becoming a Battersea ambassador.
No, really?
Yes.
I could think of nothing nicer. Nothing nicer. When do I start?
Fantastic. As ambassador, I get to come here whenever I want and promote Battersea and rescue dogs to the world. It's the best job ever.
We have one thing that we would like to give you. Come with me on behalf of everyone and all our animals. Thank you.
Of course, it's boss there. Oh, don't. Oh, that is lovely. Oh, God. Go. Do you know what? I've held out in here. I've seen abused dogs and all sorts and fell in love with dogs and I've held it together and I thought, I ain't crying on the telly. This is filling me off.
It's your boy.
It really has me, well, me familiar, me buster. Thank you so much. I can't speak. Thank you.
Buster was me dog who died nearly 3 years ago.
He lives on in Battersea and he's the spirit of Battersea, Buster, because he was dumped. And it's just lovely that he's here, it really is.
Now, even though I'm going to be sticking around here at Battersea, we're still coming to the end of the series. But I think before we say our farewells, you'd like to know what happened to Bourbon and her puppies, wouldn't you?
Oh, my
I think you're going to be in for a shock.
Oh, look at these. Oh, please, look at you.
How big were these the last time you saw them?
They were tiny.
The pups are now 6 weeks old and already nearly as big as their mum. Here's shortbread, jammy dodger and custard cream.
Sparky.
There's nothing nicer. Than the smell of a puppy.
I'll take your word for it.
And honestly. Listen to him, tough. How many are looking for homes then?
Yeah, well, a couple of the pups have got homes already, and the other one's still looking for one, but.
Which one's looking for a home? Little
this,
one.
This one here, but unbelievably.
Let's have
but
a look.
It's going to take very long, is it?
When I first got Buster, he was no bigger than this. I just want to show this one to somebody. I'll be back in a minute.
Where's he off to now? You need him on a lead.
I'm just having a word with my probation officer, Joan.
Won't get much bigger. I think Joan has to come.
What a sweetie. What can I say?
I'm an ambassador now, you see, so I can't just walk out empty-handed. It wouldn't look good, would it?
I've got a horrible feeling. We've got to the last day of recording and... We're adopting.
Yeah, I'll have shortbread. Yeah. Meet the new member of the O'Grady family, shortbread. Yeah.
There are so many dogs here I could have taken home with me, not least my true love Carmine. But the difference is, my dogs will accept this little one, and I can take him everywhere with me.
So we'll do the rounds, theatres, tele studios, radio. He'll have a lovely life.
What have you got in the jacket?
Nothing.
What have you got in the jacket? Come on, hand it over.
Before you kick off, madam, I've got something here I'd like to show you. The paperwork for my new dog, whom I have adopted. So, I'll see you in court. Ta-da!